Good morning, children. Today we are going to start chapter 7, respiration in plants. Children, you have heard about respiration and you all know about respiration. That respiration, it is the process of taking off oxygen and giving out carbon dioxide. Now this oxygen, it is utilized the breakdown of the food particles in our body. So children, like animals, plant also require energy for carrying out their activities. So in this chapter, we are going to learn the two kinds of respiration, aerobic and anaerobic respiration, and in which a diffusion of respiratory gases occurs and other experiments also. So what is respiration? So all living cells, you know children, whether it is a plant or animal, they require energy for the various body activities like building up of proteins from amino acids, making starch from glucose, absorbing minerals from the soil, laying down cell walls by the plant cells, and many other activities. They all require energy. So where this energy comes from? So this energy, it is available by the breakdown of glucose, which is a simple carbohydrate. Now the chemical breakdown of glucose, it occurs by utilizing oxygen, and it is represented by the following equation: C6H12O6 plus 6O2 is equal to, it is giving carbon dioxide, water and energy. That means food, which is in the form of glucose, it combines with oxygen and it releases carbon dioxide, water and energy. So there are three important things in this respiration equation: the breakdown of glucose to carbon dioxide and water. So the breakdown, it doesn't occur in a single step, but it occurs in a series of chemical steps. Now there are two main phases to carry out these steps: glycolysis and Krebs cycle. Now this glycolysis, it occurs in cytoplasm, and Krebs cycle, it occurs in mitochondria. That means glucose is changing to pyruvate, and in Krebs cycle, pyruvate is changing to carbon dioxide plus water and energy. Now every step or every breakdown in respiration process, it carries out with the help of a particular enzyme. Now this energy, which is liberated by the breakdown of glucose molecule, it is not in the form of heat, but a large part of it is converted into chemical energy in the form of ATP. Now the full form of ATP is adenosine triphosphate. Now when energy, it is in the form of ATP, it converted to ADP when it is not in use. And whenever this ADP energy is required, so again the energy is available by further breakdown of glucose, and this ADP, it is reconverted to ATP, and the process goes on. So one mole of glucose molecule on complete oxidation, it gives 38 molecules of ATP. So here children, breakdown of food. So glucose, it is breaking down into carbon dioxide, water and energy. Now this energy, it is in the form of heat, and it is also in the form of chemical energy. So this ATP, again it is used in the work, and then phosphate group is here, and then when it is not in use, it stores in the form of ATP, and again whenever the energy is required by the body, this ADP again with the addition of phosphate group, it reconverted into ATP. So in this form, the energy is utilized in the body. Now living organisms, They show two types of metabolic activities, anabolic and catabolic. Anabolic is the constructive process in which energy is consumed, whereas catabolic is the destructive process in which energy is used by the organism. So respiration, it is a breaking down process in which living cells, they oxidize organic substances and release carbon dioxide, water and energy. So respiration, it is a catabolic process of releasing energy from glucose, and this energy, glucose is utilized, or energy is utilized for carrying out life processes. Now come to respiration versus burning or combustion. Children, sometimes respiration, it is compared with the burning, like the burning of coal. Why? Because both liberate energy and both gives the end product carbon dioxide and water. But this comparison, it is only superficial. Now the differences between the respiration and burning are, respiration, it is a cellular process, whereas burning, it is non-cellular process. It occurs at body temperature and burning occurs at high temperature. Now respiration requires series of chemical steps, whereas burning occurs in a single step. It carried out with the help of enzymes, whereas burning carried out by heat. Respiration, it is a biochemical process, whereas burning, it is a physicochemical process. Now energy, it is liberated in the form of ATP in respiration, whereas all the energy, it is produced in the form of heat and light. So no light energy is produced in respiration, whereas in burning light energy is produced. Now come to the plant, children. As you know, children, the entire plant respires, like the leaves, stem, roots, and even the deepest cell, which are placed in any region, they respire. Oxygen in plant, it is obtained from the atmosphere through three different inlets, like stomata in leaves, lenticels, general surfaces of the leaf. You know, children, you must have seen the farmers, they plow or till their soil. Why? Because plowing or tilling of the soil, it creates tiny spaces in the soil particles and provides source of oxygen for the roots. Waterlogged and compact soil, they does not allow air spaces through which affect the respiration process of the roots. During daytime, children, due to photosynthesis, the leaves, they produce oxygen, which is utilized in respiration, and the rest of the oxygen, it diffused out into the atmosphere. Now the carbon dioxide, which is produced during the respiration process, it serves as a raw material for the photosynthesis. During night, children, when the leaves, they obtain oxygen from the atmosphere and give out carbon dioxide, so we should avoid sleeping under a tree during the night. Now two kinds of respiration, aerobic and anaerobic respiration, children, we'll learn in our next class. Thank you and have a nice day.